What is up, guys? Pro Player Apathy here, back with a new tip video. Today we're going to be talking about something pro players abuse. Now, all pro players do this, and they've been doing it for years and years, and it gives you such a big advantage mid-game. We're going to start off the video explaining you guys how to kind of camera and show you guys how broken the camera system is and how broken angles are, and then we're going to go into some gameplay showing you how to camera, giving you guys tips during the gameplay, and executing all the cameras and all the brokenness of this game. You guys killed it on 100% pro players do this in Modern Warfare video. Let's kill it in this one. Make sure to like the video, especially if you learned something. Subscribe to the channel, guys. We're so close to 150K subscribers, and I'll see you later. All right, let's do this. Like, I see half your body.
Oh my God.
I literally see half your body.
I literally can't see a single ounce of yours.
All right, guys. So the first thing when it comes to broken angles and broken cameras, this is actually a big problem. It's a bigger problem in Modern Warfare as well. So obviously right now you can see basically almost half of his body, but he can't see none of mine. And this is actually absurd to think about how like the right angle has the advantage because your gun is on the right side. So you got to take into account when you're playing around the map, maneuvering around the map, that this is a thing. In my opinion, if you can approach gunfights from a right angle over the left, and that is a pretty big thing when it comes to like breaking cameras. And I'm gonna show you guys really quickly how insane this is, because now if I push up closer, he's gonna be able to see me. All right, Matthew, I'm gonna push up a little bit closer. Let me know when you can see me.
I see you, and okay, I can see you.
All right, guys, not to show you how broken camering is, I'm coming from the left side, and I'm gonna challenge my friend over here, Matthew, on a head glitch. Now he should have the advantage, right? I'm also coming from the left side, and like I said, the right side is better to challenge from, and he should have the advantage, right? Well, he is shoot to kill, so let's do this. Pretty insane, eh? On a head glitch, man. All right, guys, for the next challenge to show you guys, now he is bottom L. I do have the right side advantage, and on top of it, he is out in the open. So I'm just gonna show you how even more insane it is when they have no advantage at all. Didn't even hit me with a freaking bullet, man. Cameras, the more you know. Pro tip, let's get it, baby.
Yeah, well, I ain't landing a bullet.
All right, guys, we have some Azir Cave here, and this is obviously a very favorable AR map, but even with a submachine gun like that, that's a pretty good camera right there. You can still dominate on this map as long as you are playing aggressive. And during this game, I'm going to try my best to just play fast, camera tons of people, and get free kills, essentially. Obviously, they're not completely free, but when you do camera people like this, go around a corner really fast, it's really hard for them to react. Now, the whole point of breaking cameras is going around a corner very fast. And I always explain to you at the start of the video, holding the right side, challenging from the right side is better. You have a slight advantage, but any advantage is a good advantage, and it's a good advantage for you because, well, you're playing a competitive game. You want any advantage you can get, even if it's a slight one. So I like to slide cancel around every corner just like that. I'll slide out again. And these guys are pretty much free kills for me. As soon as I come around the corner, like as soon as I jump out, he's dead. They're basically dead. I could run back, jump out again, he's dead. So you can see how broken camering is. And I kind of showed you guys that at the start of the video, you know, giving you guys some tips and ideas and pretty much an example of what camering is. But it's actually really, really broken. And it's been a broken thing in Call of Duty, but it's even worse online. It's a little bit better on LAN. But obviously, especially like the casual player, the public player, you guys don't really play on LAN. We play on LAN because of tournaments, you know, cash prizes, trying to make the playing field even. So right here, there's obviously a guy in the hill. I'm assuming he's in the right corner, so I'm just gonna jump out, hit a nice little bunny hop. He didn't react, obviously. He's maybe not the best player in the world, but even if he would have shot maybe a bullet into me, I still would have killed him easily. So right here, this guy's shooting at me. I'm gonna slide cancel this, slide cancel, don't see him. Now I had the right angle advantage, but now coming through the left, it's a little bit worse. And as I always try to explain that, like you wanna slide cancel around every corner. So this guy, right here, they should be spawning back cave. And this is kind of a random tip, but I kind of talked about this briefly in my how to slide cancel video. When you are slide canceling, you always want to slide cancel around a corner. That's pretty much the main time you should be slide canceling. You know, they asked me like, Apathy, when should I slide cancel? I kind of know how to do it now. Well, you want to be slide canceling around almost every single corner. If you ever watched me play, I tend to slide cancel a lot. Slide cancels around corners, especially on little head glitches. I do talk about that a little bit in the video. Slide cancel around here. Camera those guys. Come back, camera that guy. That's not as strong as the camera, but it's a mini camera. Usually the aggressor is gonna win the gunfights, and especially when it comes to slide canceling out, jumping out, and just catching someone off guard. So that's why usually it's better to, you know, if I'm right here, sometimes this is kind of worse for me, just sitting here pre-aiming. Now if I'm on a head glitch, you know, it's not as bad because you have a little bit cover, you have more advantage to help you secure that kill. But basically, you know, you always want to be the aggressor. You know, if you think someone's around a corner, you want to be the one to jump out. You want to be the one to challenge out. If he gets behind cover, well, now maybe you're stuck. Now you're actually in a bad spot. Oh, I stopped shooting this guy. There's actually two mids. So here, slide cancel, slide cancel, slide cancel, slide cancel. Chow, this guy's... And now this has been a problem for a very, very long time. This has actually been for at least a couple years now with the cameras, with the broken system, especially in games that you can abuse fast movement. So slide canceling is a way to break the camera. It's a way to challenge someone around a corner. You can jump shot, you can bunny hop like that, and just anything to come around the corner really fast. And usually using the double tactical sprint is the key to that. So you notice, like, I'll usually tactical sprint into everything. So I'll tactical sprint to slide cancel, tactical slide cancel. Oh, choke some shots there. Tactical sprint to a bunny hop or just a jump shot. And the tactical sprint just gives you a little bit more momentum, gives you a little bit more movement. And you always want to be tactical, using tactical sprint to, you know, basically use more momentum and hit some crazier movement. So right hand advantage right here. This guy's going to try to slide cancel me, but I have the right hand advantage. Going to basically screw that guy over by slide canceling right and then challenging him. So I'm going to show you real quick. Okay, ready? Challenge. Ready? Challenge. Easy kill for me. He's on a head glitch too, mind you, and I was on a decent head glitch too. Right there, same thing, right hand advantage, and I'm coming around the corner pretty fast to obviously kill him. Now another thing about when to slide cancel, since we're talking about cameras and slide canceling and all that things, slide canceling, also obviously you want to do it around corners, but also when you think you're about to get into an engagement, you want to stop the slide cancel. You don't always want to be slide canceling, like slide cancel, slide cancel, slide cancel. Because that's actually going to get you killed sometimes when you OD do it. You're just doing it way too much. Oh, this guy's actually here. So to give you an example, okay, I'm slide canceling, slide canceling, slide canceling, nothing, slide canceling, nothing, slide canceling, slide canceling. Oh, there's a guy. I'm going to stop the slide cancel. Obviously, challenge. Go up here. Slide cancel. Challenge. Slide cancel. Wait, there might be a guy here. Hold a little preem. Slide cancel. Oh, then slide cancel there. Kind of messing my movement. So essentially, when you're anticipating a gunfight, when you're anticipating someone being somewhere, that's also when you want to stop the slide cancel. You don't always want to slide cancel into a gunfight. Yeah, slide canceling is good, and it obviously can help you get some kills, but it received a nerf about a month ago or a month and a half ago where they nerfed it a bit. It used to be a little bit more broken than what it is now. So the pull-up time isn't like some godlike pull-up time. Like, you do pull up your gun a little bit slow, but the animation of the movement helps you still secure kills and break cameras and all that good stuff. So you don't always want to slide cancel into a gunfight. Like, obviously, like, sometimes it's okay, but the goal is not to always do that. So if you're anticipating someone, obviously, if you're standing still, you can see, like, I slid cancel, but then I immediately got off the slide animation and got ready for a gunfight. Like, I went like this, slide cancel and then challenge, and I stood still and challenged. I was ready for that. Oh my god, there's so many people coming here. Slide cancel out, jump back, slide cancel again to the left, pre-aim. So essentially, obviously, if you're standing still, the pull up time is really insane. Like, look how fast I pull up. When you do this, it's like kind of a slower pull of time. You can notice it. See, it's like a little bit slower. So that's why the burger walk is actually really popular. So when you burger walk, it's hard to do with auto attack sprint, but you basically walk around corners. You snap in so fast because off sprint is slower, but you snap in so fast when you're walking or just standing still. So that's why a lot of pros tend to do the burger walk. So you want to slide cancel. Okay, there might be a guy here now. I unslide cancel, get ready for the gunfights. There's another guy on me. Obviously, being really good at breaking the cameras and, you know, coming around corners and all that stuff really fast. One, you need to have somewhat decent movement. Obviously, if you have terrible movement, you're not going to be able to just completely break the cameras and absolutely just world star people. Two, you also have to have somewhat good aim. Now, I have made 2 videos on how to improve your aim. If you want to get your aim a little better, I did make the video, the big video on how to slide cancel. You guys loved it. And this is more in-depth video about breaking cameras. So you always want to basically try to get your aim a little better, make sure your movement is pretty good, and then just practice it, you know, abuse it. Pro players abuse this all the time, man. Every single pro player does it. Every single 1000%. Everyone uses it. Everyone does it. It's just part of Call of Duty. It's something that gives you a slight advantage sometimes. And you know what? Us pro players are competitors. We compete for a lot. We play for prizes, tournaments, pride, you know, championships, trophies. Like, we want to be the best. And if this is what is in the game now, it's a broken mechanic, then, or a broken system, then we're going to abuse it, you know? So hopefully this video has taught you a lot about breaking the cameras. It's a more in-depth video. I have never really done a really in-depth depth about breaking cameras, like I mentioned it in tips and stuff, but this is like basically a full video on it and more tips about it. Hope you guys learned something new today, man. Make sure to smash that like button. Let's aim for 1,000 likes. You guys killed it with the how to slide cancel video. Let's kill it in this video. This has been your boy Apathy. Love you guys as always. Thank you for the support. Appreciate you guys. Subscribe to the channel for more tips and gameplay, and I'll see you guys next time. And if you really enjoyed it, man, leave it down in the comments below. Peace out.